Carver here. My website is at nebulaphotos.com. If you haven't watched the first two videos in this series is all about cable management. One of the things I realized after I got all of my cables and devices on top of my imaging telescope is that I needed a safe way to transport that. So I went out and bought a big plastic bin and built a travel case that could support everything very securely. I don't have to worry about it getting jostled on like a car ride. That was my main worry because I'm often traveling to dark sites in the car with my whole imaging rig, and I wanted to just have a really safe solution to do that. So this video is going to be about how to construct one of these yourself, just to give you an idea of what this is. Again, just a heavy-duty plastic box from a home improvement store. It has latches on each side like this. Underneath that, I have a big piece of high-density foam covered by some leatherette, which is vinyl. And what this does is that it pushes down on the top of the imaging scope gently to keep it secure in there. Because there's some room in here, so it can grow a little bit in height, but this just gently keeps it so that it's not going to like jump up and hit the top or something like that. And you'll see in the video, but this is just glued to the top. Very simple. All right, and then there's my whole imaging system right in there. And so you can see I have a guide scope. I have all kinds of different devices, the pocket power box, USB hub. This is something for my DSLR. Underneath that, I have my, underneath the pocket power box, I have my focus controller, my focus motor that's from Optek, called the Focus Links. And all of that is sitting on this dovetail plate. All the cables you can see mostly are connected, at least on one side. I usually disconnect them from the USB hub just so that they're not like sticking up awkwardly, and then just, but they're still connected on one side, so I can take the whole thing out of here and just connect them all to the USB hub, and then I'm ready to go. This has high density foam on both sides, in the front and on the back. And you can see it can jostle a little bit, but it's not going to jostle around too much. If I take the whole thing out of there, you can see at the bottom, can you see that? Let me try to get it pointed towards the light. There we go. At the bottom, I have some anti-fatigue mats glued in. And then the high-density foam is just covered with a nice vinyl leatherette, just so that it's not breaking away little pieces when I put things in and out of this. So this is a really easy solution. I think the whole thing cost under $50 for a custom case. And so you could, you know, go something a lot better than this, like a Pelican case with custom foam inserts cut out by a company. But I didn't want to spend that much money, especially since this is not a system that I would ever fly with. It's really just a system that I'm going to use here locally or on road trips. So, what the rest of this video is going to be is I documented making this a little bit, and so I'm just going to talk through what I did to make it, and so you can follow along and design your own. I'll put some more resources on my website and link them below if you're interested. If you have any questions about the build process or about, you know, making a custom case, please let me know. I'm new to it. I just sort of came up with this idea on my own, didn't read anything, just sort of figured it out as I went along. So if you have better ideas, you can share those in the comments too. All right, without further ado, here's the build process.